Sunday's ring eclipse will provide a practice for scientists hoping to gather data during the fleeting moments of the total solar eclipse that will cross the United States on August 21. During the total solar eclipse that will take place in August, scientists located across the U.S. will be struggling to collect data in the 2 minutes or so that the moon covers the entire disk of the sun. There is a lot of science that can be done during an eclipse, including studying how sudden darkening of the sky changes conditions on Earth, such as rapid falls in air temperature. A total eclipse also provides a totally unique view of the outer atmosphere of the sun, called the crown. Jay Pasehoff, a professor of astronomy at Williams College, Massachusetts, may be involved in more scientific research related to the total eclipse than anyone else on the planet. Not even he can know exactly how many, but this Space.com reporter tells by at least 7. Tomorrow, he and some of his collaborators will be in southern Argentina, observing the annular solar eclipse, when 99% of the sun will be covered by the moon, as a practice for the main event of August. Total Solar Eclipse 2017, Route, Mapped View and Photo Guide. Pasehoff said he figures people are asking him to get involved with his solar eclipse experiments because he has a lot of experience watching them. He has personally been in 33 total solar eclipses, 15 partial eclipses and 16 annular eclipses. On Sunday he will be 17. Total solar eclipses occur about once every 18 months but are only visible in a relatively small area, as opposed to partial solar eclipses or lunar eclipses, which are often visible across multiple continents. In 2015, Pasehoff traveled to Svalbard, an island in the northern Norwegian archipelago, to see the total solar eclipse. Meanwhile, he and his colleague Marcos Penaloza Murillo, a research scientist at the University of the Andes in Venezuela, measured the temperature change that took place when the sun began to glide behind the moon. The temperature dropped from about 8 degrees Fahrenheit to minus 7 degrees Fahrenheit in less than an hour, with a dramatic drop occurring immediately after the sun's disk was completely darkened.